Hello, Cloud Gurus, and welcome back to the very first AWS This Week of 2022. And there are some very cool announcements this week, including AWS Data Exchange for Amazon Redshift is now in general availability. Lambda now directly supports IPv6 for inbound connections. And Amazon Translate announces profanity masking. You're watching AWS This Week with me, Faye Ellis. AWS Data Exchange for Amazon Redshift is now in general availability. And if you haven't used Redshift before, it's a data warehousing solution which allows you to run complex analytical queries on data stored in data lakes and databases. And the AWS Data Exchange is a service that enables you to access and use third-party data for analysis. For example, news data from companies like Reuters. So this new announcement means that it will now be really easy to locate and subscribe to third-party data in Data Exchange and use Redshift to directly query the data and even join it with your own data. Lambda now directly supports Internet Protocol version 6 for inbound connections. And this is very cool because it means that you can now invoke Lambda functions over IPv6 without having to worry about translating between IPv6 and IPv4. And this new capability is made possible by Lambda's new dual stack endpoints, which support both IPv4 and IPv6. So when a client makes a request to a dual stack endpoint, the endpoint resolves either to an IPv4 or an IPv6 address, depending on the protocol that's being used by the client. Amazon Translate now includes profanity masking. And if you are not familiar with Translate, it's a machine learning powered service which allows you to translate plain text from one language to another, allowing you to easily build applications which support multiple languages. Now, this new profanity masking feature detects words that AWS have categorized as profanity, and it will mask the word using a Grolix string like this. And don't worry, this feature is optional, and it is something that you will have to go in and enable if you would like to use it. Now, this might sound a little bit like censorship, but what do you think? Is this a feature that you would ever use? Let us know in the comments. Well, that's all from me. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus. Take care of yourselves, and I will look forward to seeing you soon.